Hello everyone, and once again welcome to WS Cube Tech English channel. Myself Umar Taskeer. Guys, in this particular video we are basically going to talk about the different campaign objectives. So as you can see on my laptop screen, we are not going to talk about these campaign objectives in very detail, or we can say that we are not going to explore what each and every campaign objective option is going to do, right? What we are going to discuss in this particular video is basically why campaign objectives are given over here, why Facebook thinks that this particular option is very important for the creation of each and every campaign, or before creating any campaign they will straight away ask you about your campaign objective, right? So let me tell you how this complete ecosystem of objectives works in Facebook, right? So see, Facebook ads, whenever we talk about Facebook ads are run by machines, not humans, and machines works on data, and that data is basically captured by your different activities that you do on Facebook, right? So suppose if you are watching any video which is related to like sports, right, Facebook will identify that okay, you have some interest in sports. If you are liking any Facebook page which is based on sports, Facebook will get a signal that okay, this person or this profile has some interest in sports, right? So this is how Facebook gets data, and then they analyze this data, and according to that they basically push you ads, right? So this is how it actually works. But when we talk about the Facebook ads, so whenever we upload our Facebook ads, or whenever we create our campaign, it is not us who drive Facebook ads or who basically shows Facebook ads to the user. It is the Facebook's artificial intelligence system, is the Facebook ad system, which is governed by the algorithms, and that system places our ads within the Facebook ads platforms, right? So whenever we are setting campaign and we are putting some settings like, okay, we want to show our ads to the people who have interest in digital marketing, or who have interest in cars, or who have interest in bikes, or who have interest in sports, and those people should be of like age 25 to 35. So whatever information we provide at the time of creation of campaign is not enough, right? When we provide this information, Facebook captures that information, and according to that information, Facebook shows our ads to different audience, right? So defining the audience is again very important thing, but we cannot neglect the aspect that okay, Facebook's advertising ecosystem is so strong to basically find the prospect. So how come Facebook advertising system or advertising algorithm is so strong? Guys, it is because of the data that Facebook has. It is because of the signal that Facebook is getting continuously from their users, right? Which is basically making Facebook ads algorithm and Facebook ads ecosystem unbeatable, right? So this is what I have written over here. Facebook ads are basically run by machines, not humans. Humans only define certain things within the campaigns, but actually the Facebook ads are placed within the different placements of Facebook by the Facebook algorithm. And that algorithm is actually driven by data. So whenever we say that, okay, we want to have awareness, so Facebook is saying that, okay, if you want to have awareness, then we have two options over here. And within this option, like brand will show your ad multiple times to the same people. That is basically brand awareness. So this is now defined by Facebook, right? What you do is you just define your object, and because Facebook has enough data, they can place your ad perfectly, right? So whenever you are saying that, okay, I want to now drive traffic on our website, on our landing page. Now, whenever you will say that, okay, I want to create a campaign to drive traffic, and you will be putting your landing page address and everything over there along with the creative, right? Facebook will place that creative in front of the people who are more likely to click on that ad and go to your landing page, right? So this is how it works. So when we say that, okay, we want to drive traffic, and Facebook basically shows our ad to those people only who are more likely to click on that ad. But the question is, then how come Facebook knows that this is the audience which is more likely to click on this ad and then go to the landing page, right? It is because of the signal that Facebook receives. It is because of the behavioral tracking that Facebook does. So whenever you are selecting campaign objective, you are selecting some settings. So whenever you are telling Facebook that, okay, I want to do the brand awareness, and you select this thing, Google will automatically understand that, okay, this person or the advertiser now wants to show their ads multiple times to the same users, right? So now the settings will be done accordingly. So this is why the campaign objectives are very important. So if we talk about the businesses, every business has long-term goals, and also every business has short-term goals, right? So every business has two types of goals, long-term goals and short-term goals. So when we talk about the long-term goals, this can be anything. This can be like, I want to achieve X number of sales within 1 year, right? So this is basically a long-term goal. So when we say that this is a long-term goal for us, this is basically a long-term objective for us. to achieve a long-term goal or to fulfill a long-term objective, we also need to create small short-term goals, right? So we have to create different short-term goals also. Now, these short-term goals will be collection of different campaigns, right? So to achieve a long-term goal, which is basically, as we mentioned over here, we want X number of sales. What we require is we have to create multiple campaigns, right? And that thing can be like a funnel also, right? So you have to create campaigns related to awareness, and then you have to create campaigns related to consideration, and then again you have to create the campaigns which are basically related to conversions, right? So you have to follow a funnel and you have to follow a process. So all these small campaigns will be working like as short-term goals for you, and they together will help you in achieving the long-term goals, right? So we have to understand that what campaign objective works on what foundation, and what campaign objective comes into what stage of our funnel, and what campaign objective will help us in moving closer to our long-term goal, right? So this is the basic fundamental behind the concept of campaign objective. And another very important thing that I also mentioned in the very beginning is that you have to understand that ads are always run by machines, and to run successful ads, what you have to do is you have to provide more and more data. So we have to understand the depth of campaign objective. So when we talk about the broad classification of the different campaign objective, which is like awareness, consideration and conversion, so you can see over here, so awareness kind of campaign is for those kind of advertisers who want to basically start promoting their product or service. So who wants that? Okay, I want people to show interest in my product or service, then they can go for their awareness campaign. And when we talk about the second stage over here, which is like consideration, which means that to get people start thinking about your product or service. So if you want people to come into the consideration stage, or if they are into the consideration stage, what you want is you can basically run all these kind of campaigns over here. So as soon as you will be clicking any one of the campaign, you will see some predefined settings of this particular campaign, which will be working on that particular objective only. Now, that particular objective will be fulfilled by the data that Facebook has, right? Now, coming back over here, we have the third option, which is like conversion. And this is purely when you want people to make a conversion, right? When you want people to make a conversion, it can be like monetary transaction and non-monetary transaction, like signups or something. So whenever you want to encourage people to purchase your product, you can go along with this conversion type of campaign objective. But yes, for this, the conversion should be set up there properly, right? So guys, I believe that now you got to know about the basics of Facebook marketing objective. From the very next video we'll be talking about in depth what are these different campaign objectives and how they actually work and what does it actually mean. So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.